We have a pleasure deficit disorder in this country. I think that there is a cure, and that cure is female orgasm.
She really was a celebrity to me. I'd seen her TED Talk 30 times.
OneTaste was a fast-growing startup in the health and wellness and sexuality space. It was all about exploring orgasm, exploring pleasure.
I saw a demo of OM. That night, the finger found a spot.
The Bay Area is a place where people are going to be attracted to and open to that idea.
As a woman, if I have to go through my life not enjoying sex, what's the point?
This was a practice that intrigued reporters whenever they heard about it. It's like, orgasmic meditation? Like, what is that?
One Taste Urban Retreat, not your average yoga studio. The pants come off the women, and soon the studio erupts in female ecstasy.
One Taste started having offices in Los Angeles, New York, London. They started selling a thing called membership that was $50,000 plus.
I was this nerdy, techie guy, starved for physical affection.
To be in a space where I could be real, it was an incredible medicine for me.
You are being completely seen.
She could cold read people with such accuracy that it could change your life. It went from utopia to a hellhole.
People were getting hurt. People were getting hurt badly.
Ex-members would describe something that might look at and think like, oh, you were being told to have sex with a customer in the hopes that that would pay money to the company.
People were psychologically brutal with each other.
And then I got a call from a source saying, yesterday I got a knock on the door and it was two FBI agents and they wanted to talk to me about what happened at One Taste. What is it about One Taste that people are drawn to? Love, connection, belonging. Who wouldn't want those things?